I'm Harry Radowski. So I'm the Livermore PI for MC, which is the Material Science and Extreme Environments Consortium. We have a very strong collaboration with UC San Diego, both with Farhat Beg and Javier Garay, and their two students, Sophie Parsons and Ross Turner. So while Sophie runs most of the experiments, Ross actually is involved with the target development.
Being at the lab has been an amazing experience for me. I've been able to participate in very large laser campaigns at user facilities like the Optical Science Laser here on site. I'm actually running an experiment that will be shooting in a couple of weeks. I've also benefited from great mentorship at the lab. I'm surrounded by a team of scientists who are the top of their field, and they've been great about imparting that knowledge onto me.
If you run into a barrier, either scientifically or programmatically, it's been really easy to get support. And there's quite a few people here who've really just taken a personal interest in my PhD journey and really helping that, because this is like 50% of my PhD, but it's really helped me get where I needed to go. And I originally was not the biggest fan of, hey, another project, is this going to slow me down? But it has really helped shape my two parts of my PhD into a really good dissertation and a really good story.
The problem we're trying to solve is really to understand how materials and lasers interact, how we can control those interactions in order to better use the energy of the laser to drive stronger shocks into our materials, enhance the pressure that we're getting off of our lasers. And we're doing that through varying tamper materials, target design, by trying to really capitalize on our understandings of laser-matter interaction. We're varying different laser parameters to try to better understand how we can best get the maximum pressure from our laser systems. For instance, a project I'm working on now is looking at sapphire tampers on aluminum. And we're trying to understand how the laser is propagating through the sapphire and whether or not that material is the best material for to use as a tamper moving forwards. We are currently in the process of commissioning a new laser called Light. Light has some capabilities we're very excited about. We are able to shoot at 1 omega, which is infrared, and 2 omega, which is green. And the plasma physics changes, a lot of the parameters that we're interested in are wavelength dependent. So being able to study the wavelength variation of our plasma generation and the shockwave generation is a capability on Light that we're very excited about. In addition, Light has a lot of pulse shaping capabilities. It's an arbitrary pulse shape laser. So we're going to be able to study the impact of our pulse shape on the shockwave that we're generating. We are currently in the process of preparing samples, and this sample preparation technique was developed as a collaboration between a lab scientist here, Allison Ackerman, Ross Turner, who is a PhD student at UC San Diego, and myself. We are trying to minimize the effect of the glue layer on our shock propagation on the optical science laser.
When I first joined this project, I was tasked with sputtering metal films on crystal or glass substrates. And I learned very quickly that sputtering is an art. It is not a click a button and walk away technique. And I spent a lot of time discovering how complicated something that seemed simple could be, and that we take for granted all of the time. I got brought onto this to this group specifically to use the ultrafast laser system. It's a tabletop laser here at Lawrence Livermore. And the idea was to have a better diagnostic setup for our laser material studies. So something we don't have at UCSD, like we are great at making materials, but needing the expertise on measuring some phenomena is what Livermore is here for. So building that kind of connection was something that we started with that setup, and we've slowly evolved to a few other types of facilities, including the optical science laser here.